126. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue was singing. Then they sang among the nations, "The Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Bring back our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. Those who sow in tears shall reap in joy. He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him." So, Lord, I thank you for Psalm 126. Lord, I thank you for this song of ascents. Lord, that your people would sing as they would come up to Jerusalem, Lord. I thank you for the fulfillment of verse 1, that you brought back the captivity of Zion. You did that the last 100 years. Lord, I thank you. You've made us like those who dream. Lord, we're dreaming with you, God, for the spiritual awakening of your people as you brought them back into your land first, knowing then that you will pour out your fresh water of spiritual renewal on them. I thank you that you're filling our mouth with laughter and our tongue with singing. Lord, I thank you for this prophecy about us, that we would say among the nations that the Lord has done great things for them. So we just say with joy, we say with laughter, we say, God, with our tongue, with singing, that you have done great things for them, whereof we are so glad. I thank you that you're bringing back continually their captivity in the natural and in the physical, like streams in the south, like fresh springs ever flowing, Lord. You're bringing them back. I thank you, Lord, even when we're moved to tears at those parts of Israel, the parts of their hearts that are not yet surrendered to you, as we sow in tears, that we will reap with joy, that this is our destiny, Lord. This is our destiny as we pray, Lord. So continue to fill our mouth with laughter, to fill our tongue with singing, to show us the great things you have done for them. Because doubtless we will come again with our arms full of the harvest. Thank you for your joy. In Jesus' name.
And I'll be reading out of Jeremiah 31, 12 through 15. They will come home and sing songs of joy on the heights of Jerusalem. They'll be radiant because of the Lord's good gifts, the abundant crops of grain, new wine and olive oil, and healthy flocks and herds. Their life will be like a watered garden. All of their sorrows will be gone. The young women will dance for joy, and the men, old and young, will join in the celebration. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and exchange their sorrow for rejoicing. The priests will enjoy abundance, and my people will feast on my good gifts. I, the Lord, have spoken. So I thank you, Lord, for the joy of Jerusalem. I thank you, Lord, that they will be radiant because of your good gifts, through abundant crops, through new wine and olive oil, God, through healthy flocks of abundant herds, God. I thank you, Lord, for your life, God, that will spring up with new wells that will flow through their gardens, God, that you'll turn their sorrows into joy, that they will dance and celebrate, oh Lord. I thank you. We give you praise and honor and glory, God. I thank you that you are going to comfort them, that their sorrow will turn into rejoicing, that their priests will enjoy abundance, and that your people will feast on your good gifts. Lord, I thank you.
What to do but shout. Rejoice, 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 for the Lord has done great things. This is